We're in the faculty gallery, as if,
as if I was a faculty member.
As if he taught somebody anything.
No, yeah, but I never taught anybody anything.
Now, the thing is that Steve has this magnificent work right behind me. This diatribe of art is built around the theory of the black swans. And there's a little write-up over here and that I'm going to try to share with y'all while you enjoy this incredible piece here. And I'll try to just walk over here and lay this black swan theory on you. The black swan theory, or the theory of the black swan events, is a metaphor that encapsulates the concept that the event is a surprise to the observer and has a major impact. After the fact, the event is rationalized by hindsight, being he's not really going to understand this when he first sees it, but after a period of time, it's going to dawn on him that the events encapsulated in this piece describe his life in some way. The theory was developed by Nassim Nicholas Taleb to explain three specific
points.
Point one, the disproportionate role of high impact, hard to predict, and rare events that are beyond the realm of normal expectations in history, science, finance, and technology. Again, the random act of painting or the random act of paint application
correlates to an event that you decided was not random anymore after it occurred randomly.
Right. And then that random event of painting actually describes
jeta, come on.
A real life action, and comes as this might seem abstract, yet is a true, very realistic depiction of life
that has occurred.
That has occurred in his life, and in fact, he's able to describe it all that more realistically in an abstract way than as if he tried to draw it out as an actual event. You're more able to encapsulate the entire event through this random painting that really has to do with a realistic metaphor and a portion of his life. Point two, the non-computability of the probability of the consequential rare events using scientific methods, owing to the very nature of small possibilities. So in fact, what we're saying here is that if he tried to draw out people in an event, he would not be able to capture all the inner realities that are occurring. But through this all-over painting method, he's better able to capture all the nuances of a specific human event.
Voila.
Point three. The psychological basis that makes people individually and collectively blind to uncertainty and unaware of the massive role of the rare event in historical affairs. Point there is that often in life, we go through certain things that are occurring around the world, and we might see them on the news, and they might occur to us in our specific family or life, or you know, the way we were driving to work, but we don't realize their historical significance in the largeness of the world as these events occur to us, because we're just part of the event and its occurrence, and it's hard to sort of grasp that event and its own individual largeness.
what we have here is an art piece that it was that occurred in the daily event of an artist, but yet that daily event of painting can all of a sudden become a historical gaffe, a gouge in life that is very meaningful, especially when the pieces turn out so nice, such as this one that's right behind me. We, myself and Steve, as artists, often create pieces, and then there's a few pieces that stand out that really sort of are, that mark a moment in our life that say, oh my God, he really has touched upon something here. I believe that this piece behind me is that type of specific landmark piece that helps define a certain moment in this artist's career. I feel that this is a landmark piece in Steve Beck's career because of its amazing way to bring together powerful elements into one piece. These powerful elements are sort of coagulated like blood on the top of a scar into one healing moment. And that is what we're talking about here, is that there's these large moments that occur that we don't even realize how important they are. But yet, it's that healing process that occurs that sort of marks the moment where life comes back together. Well, I want to thank Steve for his own artistic revelations that he gives visually as well as bothering to try to explain these things, because often in the art world we're left looking at a piece and not really understanding where the artist is coming from. I believe with a little bit of hints from the artist himself that these pieces can become even more influential upon the viewer. I'm not really trying to explain it in its entirety, and we're not really trying to take away from what these pieces will mean to you individually, but we're trying to give you a little bit of background information and things to run with. It's sort of like knowing the history behind a piece will give it more relevance in the future.